I read the Quran, and I think reading the Quran, Islam should be declared a crime against humanity.
Over what?
Crime against humanity.
Over what?
Well, crime against Jews and Christians.
Okay, over what?
Crime against women.
Okay, okay, okay.
Crime against people who leave Islam. Crime against, you know, anyone who wants to make sense. So please explain to me. Please explain to me. Where is the problem? Have you ever read the Quran?
Yes.
What is the treatment of Islam, the Islamic theology, towards Christians and Jews?
You tell me.
Have you ever read the Quran?
Jizya tax.
Have you ever read the Quran?
Yes.
What do you understand when reading the Quran as to how Jews and Christians ought to be treated?
Treated in what sense? In war?
In what?
What sense? What way do we treat them? In Darul Harb, in Darul Kufr, in the non-Muslim land, in a Muslim land, what are you talking
about? The Quran doesn't have...
What do you mean treating? What do you mean treating?
Once. In the Quran,
yes.
There is no such thing called non-Muslim land, Muslim land. You understand that?
Yeah.
So don't bring in irrelevant points. The Quran is very clear as to how Jews and how it views Jews and Christians, how Muslims should view Jews and Christians. Based on the details that you've read from the Quran, why do you think Islam should not be declared a crime against humanity?
What's your problem with it? I'm not gonna go.
Okay,
on
I'll give a list. Sure, sure.
You tell me what's your problem with it.
Sure, sure. Let me give you some details. Let me give you some details, and you can then defend. Yeah. The Quran. One second. The Quran. The
Quran. Stop. I'm Christian. You're Christian, but Christianity.
The Quran.
Christianity. Should pay for its crime that he have against people as
the
well.
Quran.
So you come here and attack about the Quran and attack about Islam, but you don't read about Christianity.
Exit
and all Christianity. All Christianity.
The Quran.
Used to kill people,
me,
as well.
We are trying
so
to have.
That was in
don't
those
touch me.
Days.
Don't touch me. Please don't touch
I'm
me.
I'm not touching you. That
you did
is,
touch me.
I don't
times.
Even want to touch you.
Okay.
That one is in those
the Quran,
days. But in these days,
the Quran
it's
things.
You understand?
The Quran
so talk
thinks,
about these days right now. Talk about these days right now. Yeah?
Sure.
Talk about these days right now. Because back then, there was a war. Back then, there was a war. Everybody killed everybody back then.
Quran.
Everybody killed everybody then.
The Quran thinks Jews are like dogs. Would you agree with that?
Where's the reference?
Surah 7, Ayah 176.
So,
have you ever read?
If it says so, you'd think Jews are like dogs?
Open the copy for me.
Surah 7, Ayah 176.
Open the copy for me.
I'd like to read many things.
Open the copy here for me. Open the verse.
Okay, let's read. So, if the Quran...
No. Open the verse in the book, please.
When we open and find out that Islam thinks Jews
it,
are like Muslims,
me.
What
Forget
are you trying
open
to do?
It for me. Let me read it.
Surah 7, Ayah 176. Had we willed, we could have raised him by their means. But he clung to the earth and followed his own lust.
Who's him?
Will. Clung to his own lust. Therefore, his likeness is of the likeness of a dog.
The likeness of a dog.
Yeah. We'll come to that in a little bit. Yeah.
You said all Jews, and now you're saying him. You're saying all Jews, and now you're saying him.
Have you ever read this surah?
You're saying all Jews and now
have
you're saying
Have you ever read this surah?
No, you gave me a verse here.
Have you ever read the surah?
No, forget that here. You gave me a verse and you said it says all Jews are like dogs. Now it says the likeness of him is like a dog. Who is him?
Yeah,
and how
can we
apply it to all Jews?
Can we? Clearly you haven't read the...
You made a claim. You have to defend it. Why are you asking me to defend it?
Let him finish. That's why he's going to come.
Go on. Let's read it.
Clearly you haven't read your Quran.
Go and read it.
And so, let me clarify. Surah 7, Ayah 159. And of Moses' people. Who are Moses' people?
Ben Yisrael.
Good.
Yeah.
So you see the context there? Moses' people.
Moses' people, yeah.
Yeah.
So,
Surah 1. No, wait.
Go.
Clearly, you haven't got a clue, and
no, you asked me.
And I'm giving
Why
you an answer.
Rude, bro, ski?
Excuse
Why
me. Look.
I'll leave right now if you're getting rude.
You can leave any moment you want, but the point is, you clearly When I read the verse that I read, you demonstrated your ignorance.
It's a singular pronoun in the verse here. How do you think it applies to a multitude of people? It says the likeness of him. Him. How is that going against
don't
the whole column of people?
Please don't.
It's okay. No, because it's shining over me. It's shining over me. As if you know more. Go on, explain.
Are you scared of reading your own
I'm
Quran?
Scared, okay. But you made a claim. You have to defend it.
That is okay. Yeah. No problem.
So now can we read once upon a time? So, please don't touch me, sir. Please don't touch me, sir.
In the Bible, Jesus mentioned dark as well. So that is okay.
Surah 7, Ayah 159, Moses' people.
We agree?
It's about?
Israel. Don't read.
Surah, the same Surah, Ayah 160. We divided them into 12 tribes, nations. And we inspired Moses when his people asked him for water and so on. So,
who are we still talking about?
You tell me. You're making a claim. You have to... Why are you asking me a question? Ask me to defend.
It's your book, isn't it?
Brother, you ask me to defend.
Are you a Muslim?
I'll defend.
You know, you clearly are clueless, so maybe you're not a Muslim. Is there a Muslim who... Are you a Muslim, sir?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So this gentleman is clueless. Have you ever read your Quran?
Of course I
did. Okay. I'm trying to read from Quran, and he seems terribly scared. And he seems to demonstrate that he doesn't know the scriptures, i.e. your Quran. So let's read this, yeah? Surah 7, Ayah 176.
This is the reason why war cannot done in this world.
This is because the reason people, why you should stay
because
away.
Because of people like these people, this Christianity. This is the reason why war and corruption cannot finish in this world. This is the reason why there will be no peace.
Where's your
in
water?
This world.
Have you got
because
water?
Because of people like this man.
This Surah 7, Ayah 176. Ayah 176 portrays Jews as dogs. Based on this, I'm trying to find out why Islam should not be declared as crime against humanity. This is what I'm trying to find out. Because you know, this is as clear as it could get. One of the most racist comments. Something that can demonstrate why the nation of Israel is currently being attacked. And so I'm trying to understand. The gentleman here has some religious clothing on. And so I thought he might know the Quran. But I read one verse. And he was scared already. Surah 7, Ayah 176. Jews are portrayed as dogs. Based on this, I'd like to have Islam categorized as crime against humanity. What would you say about that?
You're clearly wrong. Show me the verses. What you're talking about.
Yeah, please. Surah 7, Ayah 176.
That was in the past. I say that was in the
Excuse
past.
Don't push.
And if you want to bring up that right now,
say
away, I say Christianity.
If you
Christianity.
That's fine. That's fine. Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
You don't touch me either.
Excuse me. Don't touch me.
You don't touch me. Yeah.
Don't touch me. Stay away.
Okay.
Yeah. You pushed. You pushed
I'm not
my.
You.
Yeah.
I'm not
who pushed
you.
The microphone? It's on record. Who pushed the microphone? Do you know who pushed? Who pushed the microphone? You touch me physically. If you don't like, you can move on. Don't touch my Quran as if you want to engage in a conversation. And at the same time, push my other hand. Please don't do
it.
Stay away if you don't like.
Clearly, clearly.
No. In our nation, when people grow up, brains also grow up and we begin using them. We are trained to use them. Clearly, you're not trained, and therefore, I really commend to you to stay away from Speaker's Corner, stay away from any public place if you can't engage in an intelligent public discourse. For other Muslims who might be intelligent, let me ask the same question again. Surah 7, Ayah 176 seems to suggest that Jews are dogs. Based on this, I'd really like to categorize Islam as a crime against humanity.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir. I'm not here to deal with your ignorance right now.
We are trying to deal with some intelligent comments.
Any intelligent Muslim who wants to engage in a conversation can begin engaging.
That's
yes,
what
sir.
You read, right? No, you read that.
Are you a Muslim, sir?
It's fine.
Are you a Muslim, sir?
I'm a
I'm asking.
You're not. Surah 7, Ayah 176. Are you a Muslim, sir? Are you a Muslim, sir? Surah 7, Ayah 176. Jews are like dogs. Is that a sensible statement to make? I think Islam should be categorized as a crime against like humanity. It doesn't stop here. I'll go through a long list for you if you want.
In a lot of books. There is a lot of
Surah 62.
Statements made Excuse in a lot me, of books.
Bring and your also, own camera, record your own stuff, sir. Surah 62. Surah 62. Are you a Muslim, sir? But are you a Muslim? Yeah, please try and explain. Surah 62, Ayah 5. Jews are like donkeys. Are you happy with this idea? Metaphor. So, would you like to be called as a donkey as a metaphor? Would you like? So you don't like it even as a metaphor. So, who cares if it is a metaphor or not? Why would you're a Muslim. You consider Quran as your word from your own God. Why would it call Jews as donkeys? Why? Metaphor, please come. Why? I'm terribly upset. You as an individual is very clearly stating, that you wouldn't be called, you wouldn't like to be called a donkey, which I completely understand. I wouldn't like to be called a donkey. Neither would my brother here and my friends here and so on. We wouldn't want to call any human being a donkey. It's not just rude. If I were to use the word rude, that'll be an understatement. The very fact is Islam is nasty, evil, wicked to the core. And the gentleman here, he hasn't read his Quran, so he's clueless. So this is what Islam does. Raises people in the millions who are clueless, mobilizes them as an army, again who are clueless. This young man...
Don't touch me. You did touch me again.
So the...
Why not?
What are you talking about? Why?
Well, why should I... Why can't I speak about you?
Why should you?
Because you touched me already. Why can't I speak about you?
I'll touch your microphone because I don't want my voice to be recorded.
What's that?
I don't want my voice to be recorded.
You know the best way to do that? Stay away.
You stay away. I'm not going to move away.
Okay, that's fine. So your voice would be recorded. The fact that you clearly can't even... demonstrate composure would be recorded. So let's go on. So Islamic, yes.
Why do they get angry?
Well, they get angry because they haven't got. They get angry because
they. Angry?
Yeah. Well, if you're clueless.
You said I was dressed in religious clothing. Is this religious clothing? You made a claim, defend it. Is this religious clothing?
What is it then?
It's cultural clothing.
Where were you born?
Huh?
Where were you born?
Don't ask personal.
Where were you born?
It's cultural clothing.
You're saying this is cultural clothing. Where were you born?
I was born here.
You were born here?
I was born here.
Okay. What's your nationality? You were born here. What's your nationality?
Don't ask silly questions.
No, I'm trying to understand what culture you have in your mind.
Don't ask about
culture. I'm really trying to understand what culture you have in your mind. You were born here. What is your nationality? What's your nationality, sir?
Don't make him ask you any question. You ask him question.
So clearly, all right, okay. Let's go through this list, my dear friends. Surah 7, Ayah 176. According to Islam, Jews should be seen as dogs. Surah 62, Ayah 5. According to Islam, Jews should be seen as donkeys. Surah 98, Ayahs 6 and 7. According to Islam, Jews and Christians are worst of creatures when they don't agree with Islam. Surah 4, Ayahs 47, 53, 154, 155 have some very nasty comments about Jews. Surah 17, Ayah 22 to 39. Friends of devil, Bani Israel. The topic, the surah's name is Bani Israel. And it goes on to describe the friends of devil. Surah 2, Ayah 65, apes. Now, let me ask you, my dear friends, how is reading going to help? How is reading going to help? Have you ever read the Quran?
Read the Ayah.
Of
course.
Have you ever read the Quran?
Yeah, of course.
So you should know Surah Surah 7, Ayah 176. You should know.
Open it, read it.
Have you ever read the Quran?
Of course. But
so, Surah 7, Ayah 176, why dogs? Why are Jews
read
like
it,
dogs?
Read it.
Why are Jews like dogs? Would you agree with that statement? If Surah, if the Quran says, if the Quran says they are like dogs, would you agree with that?
It doesn't say that.
Would you agree with that?
I can open it.
Would you agree with that? Would you agree with that?
I'm saying open the book.
Would you agree with that?
You don't know.
If you don't know, just say.
You don't know.
Good. How old are you now? How old are you now?
You don't know why.
Hey, what religion are you?
How old are you?
You don't know why.
No.
You don't know why.
I am a Christian. How old are you?
Christian, I can say Bible verse 1, this says X, Y, Z. Open it, let's read it.
My dear friend, how old are you?
You're making baseless statements.
In the ancient affairs.
I am making, so according to the Quran, how should Jews and Christians be treated? You tell me.
Open the book and
we don't know.
Jews and Christians who don't receive Islam, what is the view of Islam of these people?
You know the verse you said, verse chapter 7, verse 1? Read it.
167.
Jews and Christians, you tell me, you have read the Quran. How long have you read the Quran? Long time? Many years? Many years. According to the Quran, Jews and Christians who haven't accepted Islam, what is Islam's view of them?
Read the
You tell me.
What's Islam's view of what? Who haven't accepted Islam?
Of Jews and Christians who have rejected Islam, who continue to reject Islam. What is Islam's view of them?
What is your view of Jews and Christians in these days now?
Yeah.
What is your view of Jews and
Excuse me, sir. You need to stand in the queue. I'm asking the questions right now.
What is your view?
What is your view?
What is your view of Jews
Don't be
and Christians in these days now?
Jews and Christians who do not accept Islam, what is Islam's view of them?
We're talking about the present now. What is your... Because we don't know what's up in the past. No, we're talking about the present now.
Why is this guy being desperate?
About Jews and Christians now in these days.
You, sir, please come here. Please come here, please. That's fine. So you tell me, what is your view? What's that? One second. Well, people who I need to love, people who the Lord Jesus Christ loves, people who God of the Bible loves. So you please tell me, sir, what is your view of Jews and Christians? Are you Muslim, sir? Are you Muslim, sir? I've answered already. People... Okay, listen to me. I answered already.
Right now, we can say him a dog.
Good. I'm going to say it second time. Please listen. People who ought to be loved, people... who ought to be spoken to and, you know, given witness to concerning Jesus Christ, but until then, to be loved. That's a view of non-Christians from Christianity. Love. Now, are you a Muslim, sir? Are you a Muslim, sir? Yeah, please, now, tell me, what is the view of Islam on Jews and Christians who do not receive Islam?
The view of is that they should be loved the same way you love your brother.
So where? Show, quote me one verse in the Quran to make that point. Quote me one verse in the Quran to make that. Excuse me, don't. Excuse me, don't lie, sir. Don't lie, sir. Don't lie. Excuse me, sir. Don't lie. Show me one verse in the Quran. Show me one verse in the Quran to demonstrate. You are shamelessly lying in a public place, sir. Show me one verse. So the gentleman says, Jews and Christians who don't receive Islam should be loved. Do you agree with that? Do you agree with that?
Let me tell you, in the Quran it says, not all Christians are the same. Some are better
not
than
all
others.
Christians. Or what?
Not all Christians are the same. Some are better than others.
Lovely, lovely.
Some are humble. Some are. So,
what is the general view of Jews and Christians who do not receive Islam in according to Islam? What's the view?
If you do not receive the message of Islam, God will judge you differently.
What is your treatment? What is Islam's treatment today?
The Prophet made a peace agreement with Jews.
Have you ever read the Quran?
Yes, of course.
Surah 7.
Let's open it.
Yeah, let's read. Let's read.
Go on.
Let's read. Whoa. Surah 7, Ayah 159. Moses' people. Who are Moses' people?
Yeah, 159, yeah.
Who are Moses' people?
The Bani Israel.
Bani Israel, yeah. Surah, same Surah, Ayah 160.
Yeah.
Moses.
160 or 159? Which one do you want to hear?
Can you read multiple verses at a time?
Which one do you want?
We're going one step at a time.
You made a claim.
We're going to 176 right now.
And you come back
do you ever read a passage?
open. Let's read it. Let's read it. See, now you're closing the Quran. Let's read it.
You know why I'm closing the Quran? Because I think you are as primitive as some of the other people who showed up here.
You're not sincere. Wallah, you're not sincere. Your heart, you're not sincere. When I tell you,
what
open
is it? Explain.
You're not sincere.
176 we are about to read.
Yeah, let's read.
Okay, let's read 176. And had we willed, we could have... Are you listening? Had we willed, we could have raised him by their means. Had we willed, we could have raised him by their means. But he clung to the earth, followed his own lust. Therefore, therefore, his likeness is as the likeness of a dog. Who is this? Who is this? Who are these then?
Subhanallah, wallah, you proved yourself wrong. This is about people who follow their own desires, their lust.
Who?
People, anyone who followed people. Look, let's read it.
So,
who raised them. Therefore, his likeness as. See, the people who follow the desires, their lust.
Yeah.
This is not about. My friend.
Who are these?
Don't. I swear, this is very. Look, if you're sincere, you'll admit you made a mistake.
Who are these?
These are people who follow their desires.
So, can we try and find out who these people are? Okay. How do we find out who these people are?
It's written here.
How do we find out who these people are?
You're not sincere, I swear.
How do we... You can swear as long as you want. How do we find out who these people are?
My advice...
How do we find out who these people are? Excuse me.
It's written.
How do we find out who these people are?
The people, to find out who they are, it's written on the verse who they are.
Yeah.
People who follow their desires and their lusts.
Yeah. How do we find out who these people are?
Listen, you're not sincere. Well, you're wasting
Thank
time.
You very much. Yeah, wasting time. You can move on. Clearly, you can't read anything in context. Okay. Have you ever read the word? Have you ever heard the word context?
Of course.
What does context mean?
I just gave you the context.
What does context mean? What does context mean?
You're wasting time.
What does context mean?
Context is the meaning behind something.
Context is the meaning behind something. Are you sure about this
word? You
tell
me, what's the context?
Context is the meaning behind something. Meaning, where is behind? Behind like that? Where is behind? Context is where you understand a verse by understanding what went beforehand to understand who were being spoken of. That is what context is. Now, would you like to find that out? Would you like to find that out? And that is where I went to Surah.
You want another page?
Are you afraid of other pages? Pages in the Quran?
No, you made a claim about one.
Are you afraid? Are you afraid of reading the other pages?
Can you give me 10 seconds to talk?
No. If you can't make sense, if you please go on. Thank you very much. Thank you.